Hello everyone, in this video we will see about plans, maps and scales. So first we will see what is a scale and the difference between engineer scale and representative fraction. Also we will see the difference between plan and a map. We will also see the examples of errors in scales, and in brief we will see about the different types of scale. So first of all, what is a scale? Suppose you have a large football ground. And if you want to represent it very smallly in a paper, if this is the paper, you try to represent the football ground in very small terms. If this is 200 meters, in paper it will be only 20 centimeters. So you scale it down. You scale 200 meters to 20 centimeters only. So this is a scale. So scale equal to length on map divided by length on ground. So this football ground, if you represent it using a very large scale, it is a plan. But if you use very small scale, it is map. So map is only for viewing purposes. So even if it is small, there is no issue. But plan, you have to plan many things in it. So it should be of large scale. Now let us see the two different types of scale, engineer scale and representative fraction. Let us take the same example. You have a large football ground. So the actual area, I mean actual length on ground, this is 100 meters and this is 200 meters. And you are trying to represent it in paper. And you choose the dimensions 10 centimeter and 20 centimeters. So if you see here, you have made 200 meters to be 20 centimeters. So 20 centimeter on map is 200 meter on ground, which means 1 centimeter on map is 200 by 20, which is this meter, 10 meter on ground. So 1 centimeter equal to 10 meter, that is 1 centimeter equal to h meter, that is engineer scale. Representative fraction is when both these are of same units. 20 centimeter is 200 meters. So you convert everything into centimeter, 200 into 100 centimeter, which is 200 into 100 by 20 is 1000. So 1 by 1000. This is representative fraction. 1 meter on map is 1000 meter on the field. So these are the two ways in which scale is measured, engineer scale and representative fraction. What are the different types of error possible in scaling? One is you measure the length with a wrong scale. Or either the map shrinks over the years. If suppose you have a map of reduced fraction h, over the years the map shrinks. So the reduced fraction of shrunk map won't be equal to h, it is different. So that is another type of error possible. Now let us see the first case example. An engineer measures the length between A and B on a map and he estimates the actual length to be 100 meters and he used a scale of 1:50, representative fraction 1/50. So actual scale is 1/100, not 1/50. So what is the actual length? So the engineer measured on the map only and he estimated it to be 100 meters on the ground. So whichever he measured here would be same. We know that scale equal to length on map by length on ground. So with 1/50 scale, he estimated it to be 100 meters. Length on map remains constant whatever happens. So because he measured it on the map only. So length on map is 100/50, which is 2 meter. But actual scale to be used is 1/100. 1 by 100 equal to L map, which is 2, 2 divided by actual length on ground. So length on ground is 2 into 100, which is 200 meters. So this is the actual length of ground. In books you might have seen the formula, correct length equal to wrong scale divided by correct scale into measured length. So if you apply that formula, wrong scale, with wrong scale 1 by 50, correct scale is 1 by 100, and measured length was 100 meters. So if you solve this, you will get 200 meter. Either you can use the formula directly or you can solve by this method if you forget the formula. Now let us see, he also measured the area of portion C as 50 meter square. What is the actual area? So correct area or actual area equal to wrong scale divided by correct scale the whole square into measured area. Here you have square because in area you have length and breadth as well. Length is also scaled down once and breadth is also scaled down. This side is also scaled down, this side is also scaled down. So you are scaling it down twice, scale into scale. So whenever area is involved, you can square the scale simply. So here actual area equal to 1 by 50 by 1 by 100 the whole square into measured area. He measured it to be 50 meter square. So if you solve this, you will get 200 meter square as the answer. Now let us solve one more type of sum. So here map shrinking sum. So here if you see on the shrunk map, he measured it as 6 centimeter, but actually it is 80 meters on ground, and the map scale read as representative fraction equal to 1 by 1000, but here it is 80 meters on ground. So what is the actual representative fraction? Simply we can solve, representative fraction equal to length on map by length on ground. Here you have length on map as 6 centimeters and length on ground you have it as 80 meters, which is 80 into 100 centimeters, 6 by 8000, 1 by 100 and 1000, 333.33. So this is the actual representative fraction. And now they have measured portion C as 200 centimeter square, and what is the actual area on ground? You know that whenever area is involved, you square the scale. So actual scale is 1 by 1333.33 the whole square equal to area on map by area on ground. Area on map is 200 centimeter square. What is the area on ground? Area on ground equal to 200 centimeter square into, if you solve this and convert into meter square, you will get the answer as 35,555.55 meter square. So this is the area on ground. Here you have one term involved which is called shrinkage factor, which is equal to shrunk length divided by actual length. It is nothing but how much this map has shrunk, by how much units this map has shrunk. So here you have shrunk length is 6 centimeters and actual length, it is 80 meters on ground with representative fraction 1 by 1000, which was the earlier representative fraction, you get it as, you should have got it as 8 centimeter, but it is actually only 6 centimeter shrunk length. So 6 by 8 is shrinkage factor, which is 3 by 4. I hope you guys understood these problems now. Now let us see in brief about the different types of scale. Plane scale, you can measure two dimensions, that is hundreds and tens, meter and decimeter. In diagonal scale, you can measure three dimensions, hundreds, tens and one hundredths, meter, decimeter and centimeter. In chord scale, you can measure angles like with the help of rectangular protractor. And in vernier scale, you can measure even the fractional part of the smallest division. You can measure even very small measurements. Like here you see, this is the object being measured. You have fixed scale as well as vernier scale. In fixed scale, it is reading as 5 meters and then you go into vernier scale. Here 0 and 0 is coinciding. Here 1 and 1 is coinciding. So it is 5.1 mm. So you are able to measure the fractional part of the smallest division. Least count for a vernier scale. Least count equal to S by N. S is the value of one smallest division on male scale. And N is the number of division on vernier scale. Here you see, if you see number of divisions on vernier scale is 10 divisions. Thank you guys for watching the video. To continue to watch more videos, please subscribe to our channel.